Okay, so now we're looking at some slightly more complicated questions with expanding brackets, but the rules are still the same, and we're still using rules that you've been using for the last couple of weeks. Okay, so first thing we want to do, order of operations. We'll do our multiply with our brackets first. So that should be relatively easy. Let's have a look. So we've got 3 times x. Well, that's just 3x. 3 times negative 5, that should be negative 15, plus 5 at the end. Yeah, because he's still tacked there on the end, he's still sitting there. All right. Are there any like terms we can put together? Yes, there are. We leave our 3x alone, because he's the only set of x's that we've got. And we've got negative 15, add 5. Ooh. Question says add 4 in the textbook. That's fine. We'll add 5. So if I've got negative 15 and I add 5 on, I end up at negative 10. Okay? Because it's negative 15 and positive 5. Bring them together, we end up at negative 10. Okay. If you need to use a number line to figure that one out, do it. Use a number line. Don't muck around. Okay. Another one. Okay, yeah, a little bit more tricky, but still following the same rules. So, here we go. Alright, 4 times 3. 4 times 3x. Well, 4 times 3 is 12. Tack my x on the end, just like we were doing with the previous ones. And then we add on 4 times 4. 4 times 4 is 16. Yeah. So that's my bracket sorted, then I'm just chucking in the stuff that I had on the end before. 7x plus 12. Now I can gather my like terms. Okay, so where are my like terms here? I've got some x's there, and I've got some x's there. So if I've got 12x there, and I've got add 7x there, I should end up with 19x. If I've got plus 16x there and plus 12x there, then I should have, oops, something happened there, I should have 28. That's it. Done. Simplified. Okay. Let's do another one. Insert equation. All right. Oh, this one's a little tricky. Definitely want to have another couple of looks at this one as we do it. Okay, key thing here, guys, to remember, the rule does not change. Same rule. Over and over and over again. So, if I chuck, I've got 2x multiplied by 3y. Now, what did we do before when there wasn't brackets there and we just had 2x multiplied by 3y? What you should be able to remember that we did is we multiplied the numbers together. 2 times 3 is 6. And then we just tacked our letters on the end because they're all being multiplied together now. So I go xy. Okay, that part's done. Then we go 2x multiplied by the plus 3. 2 and 3 is 6. So I've got plus 6x because the x gets tacked on the end there. Okay, just going to drop that down a little line so it's easier to see. Then I've got my plus and I move on to my next set of brackets. Rules are still exactly the same. 3x multiplied by y. Well, once again, because I'm just multiplying by a letter, I can just tack them onto the end of my letters. And then I've got 3x multiplied by 1. 3x multiplied by 1 is going to be 3x, because anything multiplied by 1 is just itself. All right. Then I am gathering like terms. So, where are my like terms? I've got my 6xy. Do I have any other xy's? Yes, I do. I've got my 3xy there. So 6xy plus 3xy is 9xy. And 6x plus 3x is 9x. Now, can I put those two together? No, I can't. That y right there makes this guy very different to this guy. Okay? Just because we've got Granny Smith apples and Pink Lady apples, does not, just because they both have apples in them, does not automatically make them both the same kind of apple. Okay? Now, just so we can actually see this rule, rule one, yeah, expand brackets. Okay? That's something we should be getting the hang of, just that part there, just the expanding of the brackets. Second step, gather like terms. Okay? Make sure you've got that copied down somewhere next to you as you're solving these questions. First step, expand the brackets. Second step, gather like terms. First step, expand the brackets. Second step, gather like terms. And we'll add more steps to that as we go, but these are the two steps that you need to know to answer these questions. All right, one last one. 4x. Oh, I'll put this into an equation. 4x, 2x, take away 1, take 3, times 2x, take 1. Alright, this one's a little bit trickier because it's got those negatives in there. Not insanely tricky, but tricky nonetheless. Just got to remember the rules for negatives and positives. So, first set of brackets. 4x multiplied by 2x. Well, there I'm going to have 4 times 2, and that is 8. I'm going to have x times x, which is not xx, it is x to the power of 2. Okay? So, multiplying by x once, twice. Okay? Next part. 4x multiplied by negative 1. Positive times a negative gives us a negative answer, which gives us, and multiplying by 1 gives us this guy here, so negative 4x. Next part we've got. Now, you've got to read this as negative 3. So that negative, that subtract sign, he's attached to our 3. They're all together. So negative 3 multiplied by positive 2x. We should get, because a negative times a positive, we should get negative 6x. Yeah? And so now we've got negative 3 multiplied by negative 1. Negative multiplied by a negative gives us a positive answer, because they're the same symbol. Anytime you've got the same symbol, we've got the same symbol makes positive answer. Negative 3 times negative 1 gives us positive 3. Then we can gather our like terms. Okay, so we've got 8x squared. That does not have a like term. X squared is its own little thing. We've got negative 4x. Take 6x. Which gives us negative 10. Oh, not up there. Negative 10x plus 3. Dunsky. That's it. Expand the brackets, gather the like terms. We'll look at more questions in class.